Hello. Hello, hello. Okay, probably we can start. Good afternoon, good evening already, everyone. My name is Alyona. I'm a manager of Master of International Business Program. Please let me know if you hear and see me properly. You can push a button with the audience reaction or put a plus. Wonderful. Great. All right. It is interesting to know which countries you represent. If you are not from Russia, please write which country you represent. You can write it in chat. Okay. Hello. Wonderful. Wonderful. Great. Great. Okay. Thank you for joining us tonight. Today you will hear a short presentation of Master of International Business Program by Academic Director of the program. Then you will meet MIB professors, alumni, and current students. After that, we will be able to have a Q&A session, and you can ask whatever you want. You can put your questions to chat or to questions section. Okay, then it's already 7. Let me introduce the founder and academic director of the Master of International Business Program, Dr. Irina Геннадьевна Kratko.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, great. First of all, welcome everyone, all our guests, participants, and I would also like to thank all our professors, instructors, alumni, current students who will also join us this evening. Well, this presentation will not take long because I want you to know that you can easily find it on our web page of MIB web page. So we'll just try to maybe focus on the most important facts today, and we'll share presentation, as Alyona said, between two of us. I will start and then I will give the microphone to other participants. Well, now you see the slide which represents our achievements, and you see that we are in top 100 master programs in management worldwide. This is the QS rating, and also in accordance with the same rating, we are number one in Russia. And so this is our first time when we keep this place, and we are very proud of it. And also the program was accredited by the Agency for Quality Assurance, and this is actually the accreditation given by employers, which is also very important. So not only in Russia, but also in other places in the world, this program is already well known. This slide shows our main features. And just for you to understand, MIB is not just the abbreviation. MIB is the brand, which gives us an idea about the content of the curriculum. And we are a balanced combination of a business degree and an international affairs degree. This is one of our main competitive advantages. And maybe this differentiates the program from other programs which may have the same name, MIB, but please take it very seriously, because our students learn not only managerial skills, but also they know political, economic, legal, and other aspects of the global environment, so which is really important nowadays, especially during the current period of time with COVID-19 and we are also trying to evaluate the results of this disease. This program is the first of its kind in Russia. It means that we were pioneers, and as I understand, we are still pioneers for MIB concept in Russia. The program is taught in English, which actually gives us opportunity to create a cross-cultural environment. This program is created for those who work and combine work and study, and I will talk about it a lot today because this is one of our main ideas. That's why classes are scheduled in the evenings and on Saturdays. And we'll answer your questions about the certain schedule later today. This program is 100% tuition-based. So there are no quotas, there are no 100% scholarships. And when you ask me why we do not provide any tuition free spaces, and you can find our approach to current trends.
Irina Gennadyevna, it seems to be a bad connection. Hello? Irina Gennadyevna, do you hear me? Okay, it seems to be some bad connections. Irina Gennadyevna, do you hear me? Okay, just a second. It seems we have some troubles.
Well, while we're fixing the connection problems, we may continue with the general introductions and the content. My name is Slava. I'm one of the lecturers in the program. And I wanted to say warm welcome to everyone who found time joining us today. We are all getting used to the new technology, and we periodically get glitches. We periodically get new platforms like this one. Ah, do we have?
Yeah, we had some bad connections. Irina Gennadyevna, do you hear us now?
Yes, I can. Yeah, so can I continue?
Mm-hmm. Still fix it.
Slava, mm-hmm. Okay. Slava, can we come back to you a bit later?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Sure.
Okay, yeah, sure. Irina Gennadyevna? Mm-hmm. Yeah, great. Mm-hmm. Yes, we can hear you. Yeah, please continue. Mm-hmm.
more details will follow. And can you hear me? Okay, thank you. So study abroad consists of our exclusive partners. So I want to pay special attention that these are MIB program exclusive partners. Of course, in addition to our exclusive partners, that have relationships only with our program in Russia, there is a large list of about 300 other universities that you can choose. Those are HSC partners, so the whole university partners, not just our programs. So we'll also answer your questions later regarding academic mobility. Then a couple of figures. Actually, this is the evolution, MIB statistics or MIB evolution. We started seven years ago, to be precise, with 20 students only. This year we have more than 100 students on the first year, and the number of foreign MIB students increased. And this is shown on this graph. Well, the main asset of our program is our professors and instructors. This slide shows only staff, professors, regular professors who work at HSC. And most of them, they teach political courses and economic courses. Financial and economic courses. The next slide represents our teaching business executives and leading experts from international sphere. And actually here I would be glad to give a floor to our teaching executives. Alyona?
Yeah, thank you so much, Irina Геннадьевна. Let's start with Vyacheslav. You already noticed him at the beginning. Slava, can you please speak now and introduce yourself? Slava, we do not hear you, do not see you. Mm-hmm. Okay, maybe Fyodor is available now.
Good evening. Yeah, I'm available and I hope that I'm online. Can you put a yes sign in the chat so I can see that? Yeah, thank you again for coming and considering that our format is kind of interesting right now because of this situation, but still I'm really glad that we have so much interest in our program. And now I'm going to tell just briefly about myself and about the program I'm doing at the course. So my name is Fyodor Vasilyev. I'm delivering the World Business Cultures course. And this is the course which I think has a really special place in the whole curriculum because you'll learn a lot about really important stuff like corporate finance, like marketing, strategy, all of this stuff, which is obviously important. And what my course is all about is that you can do all that. You can successfully implement all that knowledge in real practice, But the problem is that you will work with people, and people are wired culturally. And all the cultures differ among each other. So the goal of my course is to give you a framework of all the necessary cultural differences which you need in the working environment to be successful, in order to be able to implement all the knowledge you gather from all other courses and to be successful in an intercultural context. By the end of my course, you'll get a framework of all the differences, and it will be irrelevant to you where you will find yourself in, whether it's China, US, Russia, is it a monocultural team or polycultural team or multicultural team? You will know exactly how do you need to adapt to a given context. So this is basically what my course is about. And if you have any questions, please write them in the chat. I will gladly answer them.
Okay. Thank you, Fyodor. Let's see if we have questions right now, or probably we can see them afterwards, after the presentation. Okay. Let's switch to another lecturer. Slava, are you available now?
Hello there. Perfect. Do you hear me? If you do, please press something. Am I? Yeah. Fabulous. Fantastic. So, second time it worked. So, as the folk wisdom says, everything should be tried at least twice. So, my name is Slava, and my day job, I'm a consultant at PricewaterhouseCoopers, where I'm a partner. I'm doing various strategy and operations projects, and I used to be a marketer a large part of my career, so kind of got very much in love with this topic, and I like sharing it. So I'm teaching international marketing strategies. I teach international market research and analysis and strategic management, which is basically a science on how to take a strategy and to implement it till the very real results. I also teach at my company a lot. So basically, you in my classes will get practically same experience as my employees at PwC Consulting are getting. And since I'm not a professional teacher, I'm basically trying to transfer and localize as real as possible corporate experience in a large multinational to a student environment of Master of International Business. I'll be happy to answer your questions later on down the road.
Okay, great. Thank you so much, Slava. The next presenter is Yuri. Are you here with us? Hello, Yuri.
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me? Okay. Good evening, everyone. My name is Gavrilo Curie, and I am teaching a course of operational and supply chain management on second year of this program. About myself, I'm head of B2B delivery logistics in Metro Cash and Carry Russia, and for over 10 years took different managerial positions in supply chain and logistics. So my course is very practical and focused on very simple things on first glance, how to deal with exact physical process in company activity in supply chain and logistics area. Basically, main topics and main areas are how to organize efficient stock management in company, how to plan and design transport network, how to build and define warehouse layout, how to connect different individual parts of activities of company into working and efficient supply chain. So goods flow and turnover will not be inefficient and bottlenecks will be avoided. My course is usually seen as one of uneasy ones because we make a lot of calculations, simulations, and also try to be close to practical environment of how it could be. And I usually ask students to deliver some real result, which is more or less reflecting how things are built in business environment of this area. So if you will have any questions you can ask, I will gladly answer.
Thank you so much, Yuri. Glad to hear you tonight. Is Dmitry available now? Can you join us? Dmitry Khakhlov, I mean, please turn on a button, go online.
Do you hear me?
Yeah, great. Mm-hmm.
So basically, I'm a managing director of Accenture Interactive, which is an arm of Accenture, which is doing all related to digital marketing, digital promotion, and digital channels related stuff at Accenture. Accenture globally is now the number one digital agency, both by the number of clients and overall turnover. So it's a good source of inspiration for teaching courses. Prior to that, I was a co-founder of Digitalism, which is one of the big digital agencies in Russia. And before that, I was with McKinsey & Company as a manager at European Marketing and Sales practice. So it's a bit of my background. At MIB, I am teaching digital and traditional channels in international advertising, which is a very practical course which would teach how real corporations should solve their promotional mix questions, both using traditional media and digital media. And as a part of this course, we would be doing a coursework where basically you would be creating end-to-end marketing execution program promoting some real or imagery product of your choice. So that's basically a bit of background.
Yeah, thank you so much, Dmitry. Then we go to next slide, because here we have Alla Dinko, one more our lecturer and also alumna. Alla, can you join us now?
Hello, do you hear me?
Yeah, great.
Hi folks, my name is Alla Dinko, and as Alyona has mentioned, I'm a graduate of MIB. I graduated in 2015, and I was lucky to be able to participate in the exchange program, where I studied in Boston at Fletcher School of Law and Diplomacy, and I also managed to do cross-registration at Harvard Business School with second year MBA students. And currently I'm working with PwC, I'm a manager, and my course is called International Business Consulting. Of course, I understand that not everyone of you want to work for a consulting firm. However, you all will be first doing projects at your work, second working with stakeholders, internal clients or external clients, etc. And third, everyone is going to be solving real problems. So our course will help you to get equipped with various practices, mechanisms, and tools, how to tackle real projects. In the first part of the course, we will talk about the theory. And in the second part of the course, you all will get a real consulting project with a real customer. Among our customers, we have big multinationals such as Henkel, Pepsi, etc. And small startups that are doing international strategies, and you guys will be participating in helping those companies develop their strategies or solving their business issues. So I will be happy to welcome you next year at my course. Thank you.
Thank you, Alla. It was great. Pleasure to see you too. Introduction of professors. We can go to next slide. As Alla already mentioned, we have consulting projects with various companies, and we cooperate with those business partners which are presented here. And I wanted to say a couple of words about Henkel. This is a country. This is a company and our first partner, and we cooperate with them during 5 years already. I will send you now a link to a video, and probably later you will want to see the video about 5 years of successful cooperation with this company. Let's go to another slide. This is a slide about our alumni careers. Here you can see companies where our alumni work, and tonight we have some representatives of those alumni. And I will ask Vincent probably to start. Vincent, are you here with us? Yes, great. Please push go online. We would like to know your impressions about the program, and also some words about your career now.
So yes, hello everyone. I hope you hear me well. Connection is quite bad in Paris. So yes, I started the program in 2015. I was doing first before I did a master's degree in France, and then I decided to do very multicultural. The program was quite amazing, and I learned a lot actually, much more than I learned actually during my master's degree in France. What I'm doing right now, so I'm working for Trésor, which is a part of Société Générale Group. A lot of you maybe don't know about this company. It's one of the biggest European bank. Maybe like the biggest European bank actually. And it's the mother company of Rosbank. For the Russian people, it might be more familiar. And what I'm doing there is I'm the head of marketing and communication. So yeah, it was quite improvement and challenging at the same time, because also when I was doing the MIB, as many of you will be, I was working on the side. I was working for the French Chamber of Commerce, and then I was working for a Russian startup. So yeah, it was really like something very challenging, but I learned a lot, and it really helped me like to improve a lot my curriculum and also my career. So yeah, that's all I have I can say.
Thank you, Vincent. Maybe you could tell us who was your, I don't know, best professor, the favorite professor, or the best course that you liked more.
Well, definitely, I liked a lot of different classes. I liked a lot of the classes from Irina, actually. Maybe I was less a good student the first year, but the second year, it was definitely my favorite classes. And also a lot about the research seminar. I gave a lot for my master thesis. I gave a lot of time and thoughts about it. It was very, very interesting and something that made me think a lot about what I wanted to do also. And also I liked a lot, as many of us, business negotiations. That will be, if it's still on the curriculum, something that a lot of you will love.
Yeah, of course. Thank you so much, Vincent. It was a great pleasure to hear you and see you. Thank you. And we have another alumnus. This is Roman Sumaykin. Roma, can you join us now?
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me?
Yes, great.
Okay, brilliant. Hello. A couple of words about myself. So graduated in 2016. Attended all the classes of our brilliant professors, who, I can be honest with you guys, changed my mind, the way I think about career and the way I do things in general. So I joined MIB program after technical university, so I had no background in finance or marketing or management, but I was willing to learn and I was willing to go abroad to study. So MIB gave me this opportunity and I spent about 6 months in Parma, in Italy, in the University of Parma. That was a great experience. After that, I came back and I finished the program and joined Accenture Consulting straight away. It was supply chain consulting for just 6 months, because after that, I decided to take part in one of the most challenging selection processes in my life. And it was in Heineken. It was International Graduate Program in Supply Chain. So I spent about 6 months for different case studies and assessment centers, both in Moscow and Amsterdam. And finally, six people from about 22,000 people from all over the world were chosen. And I was lucky enough to be one of them. So after that, I've been working for about 3.5 years for them now. I managed to work in 4 different countries. I started in France, I moved to Mexico, then Nigeria, then the UK, and now I'm back to Russia. And I will be happy to be responsible for digital supply chain in Heineken Russia after all this program. So I don't have much time. If you have any questions, please give me a shout. I will leave my LinkedIn profile in the chat. And as we say in Heineken, go places and open the world. And I can tell you that 5 years ago, MIB program opened the world for me. Thank you very much and see you soon.
Thank you, Roma. You also opened the world for us as well. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Great. Yeah, we're done with the alumni for this time. And we have 2 students with us tonight. One from first year and another one from second year. Let's start with second year, I suppose. Dmitry, can you join us now?
Hello, everybody. Can you hear me? Can you see?
Yes, great.
Well, welcome, everyone. So my name is Dmitry Nikonov. I'm the second year MIB student. Well, I can say a lot about the program, what benefits, knowledge, competitive advantages you will be able to get when you go through this program. But to be honest, if I do this, I mean, if I say everything to you now, it would be not fair from my side, to be honest, because I will just deprive you of this amazing chance to go through this journey and learn everything by yourself. That is why I will not spoil this unique advantage of your study on MIB, of potential study, and keep this chance for you. But what I want to say, just a couple words, that you could be confident that you will get next 3 things only here on in this program. So the first one, you will get the practical knowledge. I mean that it helps you a lot when you go to an international company, when you will apply there. So the second, you will be part of the unique professional and international community, with the international students and with the teachers, with the instructors from the huge companies with a huge experience. And the third is that you will be demanded. I mean that during your study, you will be demanded because you will be able to study and to work if it's interesting for you. But on the other hand, you will be demanded when you graduate this program. So that's why, I strongly recommend you to take a look. Okay, if you have any questions, please welcome. I will be happy to reply. This goes also this idea with the sharing LinkedIn profile. I think I will also can do this. That's why anytime you can ask me. Thank you.
Thank you, Dmitry. Thank you so much. Then let's switch to a first year student. Askar, are you here with us now?
Hi, can you guys hear me?
Yeah, but maybe better to turn off the video because the connection is not that good.
Mm-hmm. I am from Russia. and I'm a first year student, but I graduated last year from Boston University, and I decided to come back to Russia to continue my education. And when looking for a program, the main criteria for me was, well, the business program, and also that it has to be taught in English. And this program has caught my eye, and I actually didn't apply anywhere else. So this was my only option. And I figured I'll figure something else out.
Yeah, sorry.
But coming into this program, I didn't really have that high of expectations, because from what I heard from my friends back in Russia, from their experience with going to university here, it wasn't the best experience. And I didn't know what to expect, but being part of this program for almost a year now, I can say that it is a fantastic program. The classes are amazing. And the fact that we have such great staff here with people who are currently practicing and actually working in the fields, that gives a great perspective on the way things work. And I think it's an invaluable experience. Also the fact that we have, that is based around the group project, personally for me, is a big part of why I like this program so much, because I believe that indicates and translates well into the time when you actually start working. And another thing was the consulting project that we are just finishing up right now. And the opportunity to work with an actual company, my team got Friesland Campina, and to work on an actual.
Thank you so much, Oscar. You can also share your LinkedIn account, probably. These introductions are finished. Now we can go to admissions. And I should tell you that the application process for international students already started in November, and it will last till 14th of August. And you can, of course, send your portfolio via the personal account. And applications for Russian citizens will open on 22nd of June. If you have any questions related to application process, you can always contact MIB managers. So here you see our email and our telephone numbers as well. And we are always available for our prospective students. Here's some words about portfolio checklist. So we do not have any exams, but the portfolio. Here you see all the elements of the portfolio, and maybe you already saw them on our website in the requirements section. What we expect for you to send us are motivation letter, two letters of recommendation, preferably one from your employer and one from academic institution. If you do not work, two letters from academic institution will be okay, but just from different about different projects. Then we also expect you to send us scans of diploma and official academic transcript or official copy of your most recent academic transcript. Please also enclose your resume, CV, specifying your education, work experience, and achievements. We also expect to see English language certificates, but if you do not have a valid one, we can have an interview with you. But first, we have to see all the portfolio. Tell me if you have some questions right now about application, or I can show you the application deadlines. Yeah, here we are. We have the deadlines specifically for foreign applicants and for Russian applicants. Let me know if you have questions right here. And let me also invite here the academic director of the program.
Yes, can you hear me? Yes, I'm really sorry for the connection. Well, unfortunately, in this compressed time frame, we couldn't say everything that we wanted to say. We have an amazing, a fantastic atmosphere at our program, and I am sure that all of us, all of our alumni and all of our current students can confirm my words. So family, MIB family, means that we trust each other, we help each other, and of course, if there are any problems, some of our students experience problems nowadays, so we are here to help all the time, like in a real family. So, but in addition to what has been said, I want to say that, again, during to a very complicated situation with COVID-19, we will change a little bit the process of the application process or the process of admission. So if you cannot get the final notarized transcript from your university, or just the transcript with a stamp of your university, so don't wait, don't hesitate, just to send us any confirmation that you can get from the office of your program. And then when everything finishes, I mean with coronavirus, then we'll add all the necessary documents in the form that was required initially. And I want to thank all our participants one more time. So stay together and please ask any questions you have right now. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Let's see which questions we have now. Mohammed asks whether his high school certificate is okay. Mohammed, we have to see your portfolio, your transcript. If something is not in order, in any case, we can ask you to have an interview with us in English. It will take like 10-15 minutes. We can do it via Skype or Zoom, so it's not a problem. Yeah, Irina Gennadyevna, I see questions about the COVID situation effects on courses. Can you comment on this? Hello?
Now, can you hear me?
Yeah, great.
Well, we do not have any changes currently, and all our courses are just going on online. Of course, some interruptions can spoil the whole impression of the students, but I think that everybody understands. And again, everybody tries to assist each other. So, deadlines are the same with term paper submissions, with master thesis submissions. The schedule is the same. So maybe the only change is that every year we have our May days from the 1st until the 10th of May. So in HSC, nobody studies during these 10 days. But this year, due to coronavirus situation, actually this was changed for the first time in our history. And we will study from May 6th to May 8th. So this is the only, I would say, interference in our schedule.
Yeah, we have a question about double degree program. Anna, can you join us? Maybe I can start answering this question. There was a question about, is it free or not, free of charge or not? I meant Anna. Okay. Did you want to comment on this? Okay.
Not double degrees, but exchange programs. Do you mean double degree or exchange programs?
There is a question from Artyom. Is double degree program free of charge? I mean, do we pay to MIB or University of Rome, USA?
Can you hear me now?
Yes,
it's okay.
Anna Kratko here. Can everybody hear me? Just say yes.
Yes.
Okay, wonderful. So I can get back to, who had a question, Andreas, about the double degree? I'm lost a little. Anyways, we have two double degrees, one with Lewis University in Rome, which is a private school, and the other one with the University of South Carolina. The Lewis degree takes a whole year, and you do it in your second year of studies, so it you don't spend an additional semester, an additional time to complete both programs, and it is free of charge. You do not pay tuition to Lewis. You only pay tuition to the HSE. The University of South Carolina degree involves an additional semester. So after you finish 2 years here in the MIB, you go to the University of South Carolina and complete their degree in only one semester instead of two, because some of your MIB courses from the HSE are transferred towards that degree. However, you pay for the whole semester worth of tuition to South Carolina. Did I answer your question? Hello?
Well, yeah, Anna, I think, yeah, it seems you answered.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you so much. What else? There was a question about, let me see. I would ask you to put your questions to a questions section. It will be just easier to follow everything. Okay. There is a question, how many people apply for this program each year? And is it possible to enter successfully if I don't have publications or internship experience? Okay,
yes, I can answer. So the cohort is very diverse. So there are students with publications and there are students with a very rich practical experience. So please don't worry if you do not have publications, just show your other achievements, maybe some projects that you participated in during your study, or maybe you have some extra curriculum. So just, of course, not in kindergarten, because some applicants provide information during their kindergarten, so please don't do this. It's a joke, of course. But regarding any achievements that you have besides publications, please include them. They will be appreciated as well.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. We have one more question from Martha. What would be an advantage when enrolling in your program?
I tried to answer her question shortly in the comments, but this
was
a broad question.
It's not that clear, but yeah, sure. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So you want me to comment or, oh, Vladimir is here.
Oh, is he? Okay, shall we first answer the question and then invite Vladimir? And also we have Melanie joined us.
Oh yeah, great, okay. So maybe let's give a word to them and then we'll answer the question about advantages.
Okay, yeah, I see that Anna also replied in chat. Vladimir, can you speak now? Let me invite you to go online, or you can push go online button, a red one. Okay, Vladimir wants to just go online. Okay, once we wait for Vladimir, maybe Melanie can go online now. Okay, just a second. Vladimir, what about you? And Melanie, just a second.
Yeah, Melanie is waiting.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Vladimir Yakovich, hello.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
That's good. Well, I prepared, I'm sorry, first of all, that I'm late because I was converting the files to show for the candidate students the presentation about business negotiations. And if you don't mind, I will show this presentation right now. It's 4 minutes only. Do you mind?
No, that's great, but just upload it to files section and then we can see it.
Okay, I'm sharing the screen, okay? Mm-hmm. Can you see anything?
No, Vladimir Yakovlevich, you should upload your presentation to files section. On the top, close to participants section and files.
Let me see, participants. Well, I press participants and where's the files? I don't see files.
It's on the right.
On the right?
From the participants.
Oh, I see. Okay, files. So, would you like me to submit the file here, right?
Yeah, just push a plus, add file, and then we can see.
Upload from computer. Okay, let me upload from computer. All right. There it is. I see it now. Okay, there it is. Let me press the button. Okay. Well, looks like I uploaded it. I don't know whether you see the file or not, but not yet.
No. you can send it to me by email. I will upload it.
Wait a moment. Let me try again. Open, and actually, it's uploading for the second time. It takes time, approximately 40 seconds to upload it. I see it on the screen. So you wait 20 seconds, and you will have. First file and then second file, the same file. So
I see now. Okay, great. Mm-hmm. Okay. Shall I push the button?
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
That's good that you like it. So, any questions? I'm available to tell you whatever you need to know about my course, and you're free to ask any questions.
Yeah, please put your questions to questions section. So now we have Melanie who also joined us. Melanie, can you go online now? Mm-hmm. Melanie?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, hello, how are you?
I'm good. So my name is Melanie, I'm from France. I did the MIB, I graduated in 2019, last year. I originally studied and worked in London, but I was in the arts industry and I wanted something to be more business related, and I wanted to study this in Russia. Rather than in France or in the UK, where everything is sort of the same, so I wanted something different. I would say that the strength of the master is the instructors, definitely, the teachers, the fact that they're practitioners to begin with. You know, Stava Bilyevsky, Brinov, there's definitely classes that really grew on me and I've learned a lot from. Also, on a professional level, it enabled me to have an internship at PwC in Russia, which definitely then helped me to have my job at Deloitte France at the moment. So I know that some of you send me questions like, you've been studying languages or literature and you don't really know if this is the right master for you to convert into a more business-related career. And I would say, well, I'm studied and worked in the arts and then ended up doing financial audit at Deloitte now. And I think that master was definitely a key element to help me do that transition. Voilà. So if you have any questions, don't hesitate, and I put my LinkedIn on the conversation link if you want to do some more private questions about detailed experiences and everything. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Melanie. Let's continue with questions. There was a question from Roman on whether, if he doesn't have a transcript right now, and it will be in a month, so will he be able to apply? In any case, you can apply, and all applications are received till August, so it's not such a big problem. And also, if you can't take your IELTS or TOEFL, we can arrange an interview in English, as we already mentioned. Let's see, about the number of places for foreigners, can it increase? Yes, Irina Gennadyevna, am I right? So we can increase the number of foreigners, right?
Do you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Yes, and actually, I would say, please don't pay serious attention to the numbers that you see. It's a formality. It's just our application or, admission department. They require us to put certain numbers, but unfortunately, they never follow our recommendations. So they put numbers they want to see, but there are no limits, and there is no difference for us if it's a foreign student or a Russian student. So I would say the process is the same.
Yeah, thank you. One more question from Anastasia. Will the university help with employment? First of all, I wanted to say that there is an HSC career center that helps both to Russian students and foreigners. And also during your study period, you cooperate and communicate with various representatives from various companies, big international corporations, and you can try to find a place there. And sometimes we also get vacations, job offers from our partners, and we'll of course send it out to our students and alumni. Yeah, okay, another question, let's see. Irina Gennadyevna, probably you could comment on this. Andreas is asking, what qualities do you particularly look for in your applicants?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I see, and he is a second year politics student in the UK. Well, we have many students with previous international affairs or, I don't know, political backgrounds, and for us, your motivation is the most important thing. If you didn't study world economy or you didn't study international affairs, you will take these courses as adaptational ones at the beginning, but we would like to see in your motivation letter what you would like to do in your life, and if you really want to work in an international company and just to make a business career. And this is why you choose this program. That's enough for us. If you are highly motivated and if you see the goal that you put for yourself, actually, this is the most important thing for us.
Yeah, thank you. Let's see what else do we have. One more. Can we make payment in two installments per year? Yes, our students pay by semesters. So you do not need to pay for the whole year, but you pay by semesters. Let's see other questions. I see that Anna already answers most of them. Great. Then, if we do not have much questions right now, I would like to ask you to fill in a short survey about the webinar, if you don't mind. Just in a second, I will send you a link.
Alyona, there is one more thing that we forget. We forgot about it. Our campus, where the MIB program is located, and I think we didn't see any questions about it.
Right.
Maybe yet, but for many applicants, this is really important. Transportation is important, and since our classes start at 6:40 in the evening, so for all the students, it's really important to return from their work on time. And we are located in the center of Moscow, so the address is shown in our presentation at the end. But Alyona also can give you a link to a tour of the campus, because this is, I would say, the main campus of HSC, with address at Pokrovsky Boulevard 11. This is a brand new campus, probably the biggest campus, not only in Russia, in comparison with other campuses that I've seen in many countries of the world. This is one of the largest and I would say the most convenient place. It works 24/7. Of course, not now. Now it's closed for everyone, but starting from September, I hope that this campus will open its doors. And you can see the visual tour. So Alyona shows the link.
Yeah, following the second link, you can see virtually how our campus looks like. It's really enormous and beautiful. We have another question from Payman. He wants to know about accommodation. Payman, we have dormitories, and all students who need the dormitory gets it.
Yeah, so please don't worry about it. 100% demands, they are actually covered.
Yeah, and the dormitories are quite modern, and our students enjoy them, I suppose. there is another question.
Oh, yes, thank you, Melanie. She confirmed.
Wonderful. Are they close to campus?
Well, they are not very close. Of course, it's not a walking distance, but by metro, I would say it's around 40 minutes total.
Yeah, we have several options, so it depends where which dormitory you get, but in any case, they're quite central. They're not that far, not in another city at least. Okay, Irina Gradina, shall we wait for other questions, or I can send a link to a survey?
Yes, you can send a link, please. Yep.
Okay. Okay, one more question. No, we still have questions. How much the customer have brochure for more? I will send you now a link to information about dormitory and accommodation.
It's actually the cost of the dorm.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Melanie already did it, so she liked the dormitory so much. Great.
So I would say that you will really be surprised how cheap is it.
Yeah. One more question from Eleonora about language courses or extra activities at HSC. Yes, we have language center, and you of course can study Russian if you want, and for international students there are 6 ECTS credits for free. If you want to continue, you can study for your expenses, of course. Now I will send you a link to Language Center, and also there is a web page about extra activities such as theater, dancing clubs, what else, travelers clubs, etc. So we have lots of things to do on campus. There was another question. Let me see. Yeah, about expenses. A question from Martha. I think we already answered. Martha, let us know if you still need our reply. Yeah, I think we already answered that.
Yes, it's about the timing. Alyona, you can actually answer.
About what? Sorry, I didn't see.
Okay, I will do it. So about timing of the classes. So on weekdays, usually students study 3 days a week. On weekdays, classes start at 6:40 in the evening, and they finish at 9:30. So it's 4 academic hours. 1 academic hour at HSC is 40 minutes. And on Saturday is a very busy day. On Saturday, students study from 10 a.m. until 7 p.m. So actually they spend the whole day on campus. But again, if you are concerned about food, there are many different places where you can eat very, very fast.
Yeah. I'm sending now a link to HSC Student Life website. This is a website about extracurricular activities. You can check them. Anna, there is a question about requirements for a double degree in the USA.
Okay, I'm on air. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, wonderful. Let me find the question. Just a second. Is it in the question section or in the chat?
In the chat.
In the chat.
Which requirements are for a double degree in the USA?
Requirements. So you have to take certain courses when you're studying in the MIB at the HSC, and we... I believe we went over a slide, if we can go back now, where we highlighted the prerequisite courses for the degree with South Carolina. I don't know, will you be able to go back to that one?
We have a short one only here.
Or just, you can go back, yeah, this one, the elective courses. So can you see it, the required for double degree in red in brackets? So these are the courses. So Global Political Economy, it's the first year elective course. Political Aspects of International Business is the second year elective. And some other courses which are mandatory, which you will take anyway. So you have to take certain courses in the MIB. And you have to have an IELTS or TOEFL test certificate with minimal scores. The minimal scores are the same as any other business school in the US, so probably around 7 minimal for the IELTS, with the 7 in subsections, and for the TOEFL internet-based, I would say 100 minimal scores required. So this is it. You don't need to take GMAT or GRE anymore. They waived this requirements beginning this year.
That's for our program.
Yeah, for our program. So this is it. These are all the, so IELTS, TOEFL, and required courses.
There is a question from Mohammed. If one can speak Arabic and English and Russian, would it be enough to land a good job?
I would say yes. Most of our students, they experience difficulties with Russian, because most of the companies, they prefer to have employees just bilingual, English and Russian, and of course other languages as well. So if you do speak Russian besides English and your, of course, mother language, that's a good ticket to find a job.
Yep. Melanie, thank you for your feedback and reaction. Let's see what else we have. A question from Kirill. As I remember, he's from St. Petersburg. So the consequences of COVID-19 won't cause any changes in the process of enrollment. Is that correct for Russian students? As for now, yeah, is already, as it was already mentioned, it won't cause. So we have the same deadlines for the applications, and it doesn't cause that much, the situation.
Maybe for early applicants, this year, some universities, they postpone their final exams and defenses, bachelor thesis defenses. So it may cause, but let's wait until we understand if we can also postpone our early bird stage.
Mm-hmm.
So until now, it's, I believe, July 7th.
Yes.
There is a chance that it may be extended, but please stay in touch with us and we'll let you know.
Yeah, of course, we will put all the information. If something is changing, we will put it in our website. But as for now, the deadlines are like this, like you see now.
Then there is a question from Vibhav.
Mm-hmm.
No, next month is okay. As we, just based on our experience, even if you submit all your documents at the beginning of August, you still have a chance to start your classes. Even if you are a little late in September, now we are thinking about additional help, additional support to such foreign students who will just come later than expected. Then we'll allow you to join classes online for the first maybe couple weeks or 3 weeks. So we are still in the process of discussion.
Yeah, the classes start from 1st September. Yeah, you already got the reply, and finish on 30 or 31st of June.
Well, usually they finish in the middle of June, so formally the end of the semester is June 30th, but there are two exam weeks at the end of June. So our professors, they prefer to actually to have their exams earlier, in the middle of June, not later.
Yes.
Well, I think, I believe that we need to close this session very soon, because only 5 minutes left. So if there are any very urgent questions, please send them to us. Otherwise, Alyona, I believe mm-hmm. that, yes, they can send all the questions, all the further questions directly to the MIB address.
Yeah, of course. As we mentioned, here is the MIB email, and you can send all your questions there. And we also can start the survey, and you can also put some questions there as well, and then later I can reply to them using your emails.
Eleonora, there is one question from Eleonora about class calendar. I think we can just send her the calendar with holidays, because we have a lot of holidays. And at the end of every module, we have 1 week off So it's really important for students who work. So we study 7 weeks and then 1 week off at the end of October. The same thing in December, 2 last weeks of December are off. Then in March, last week of March is off. And as I said, we usually finish in the middle of June. So this is the calendar.
Yeah, I can send you now the general academic calendar, but if you check it, so the weeks that are for you can check the general academic calendar that is valid for all HSC, and later I can provide you with a more specific calendar for MIB program if you want.
Two more questions. Visit the campus beforehand? Well, you can visit if you come to our office and we'll give you the pass.
Yes, but I think it's the question from an international student, so first you have to get a visa.
Yes, but I anticipate that actually this person has the visa.
One more question.
And can you order or can you about the dorm, there was a question.
Yes.
You can't. Yes, you will be placed after you sign a study contract with the university, and then you will be automatically placed into one of our dorms.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we were right about visa.
So get the visa. If you want to come, you can get a tourist visa. But there are also, I heard today that the government wants to change a visa procedure. If you come here only for 3 days, you don't need a visa if you have a return ticket on hand. Yes, this is a very, very new initiative. I just heard today on TV. If this works, if this is true, then all our applicants, they can come to see the campus and make their final decision. We'll see.
Yeah, it's a great chance, actually. Yeah. Okay. Shall we switch to a survey and finish this session?
Yes, please, Alyona.
So now I'm sending you a link to a very short survey. It has only 3 questions. After each, please pass to another one, and it won't take much time. It's just the survey about the webinar. Was it useful for you? And also, if you have other questions, but you wanted to send them to us directly. Thank you so much. Thank you. We thank the professors and our alumni and students, of course, for joining us. It was a very great pleasure to see and hear the feedback.
Well, can I interrupt you for a second? I want to use this opportunity and say hello to Vincent. Vincent, I'm I'm so happy to see you. I'm with you.
Yeah.
And Melanie, if she is still here with us. Melanie, I also wanted to say hello and thank you so much. Yeah, she's here. Great. Come to see us when you are in Russia, please. We miss you.
Yeah. Lovely. Yeah, I see that our participants already reply. That's great. Thank you, too.
We look forward to it. Yes, Melanie.
Of course. Okay, thank you so much for those who replied. Thank you. So I suppose the webinar was useful due to the replies. And also we asked about additional webinar on MIB application process, and I see that there is an interest. Mm-hmm. And we will think over about arranging a webinar like this. Thank you for participating and replying, and you're always welcome. Please do call us or write to us. Thank you again.
Thank you very much, Alyona, for monitoring this webinar. You did a great job.
Thank you too. I think we are a good team.
Yes. So then, goodbye.
Yeah, bye-bye. Thank you so much. Thank you all.
Bye all.
Yes.
Yeah. Show ourselves now. Thank you. Goodbye. Bye-bye. Okay, I'm stopping the webcasting. Bye-bye all.
Bye. Bye.